in life, suffering can be perceived as negative. Everyone has their own suffering. Everyone can feel their own pains. Each is different, yet each can lead to the same beautiful place if you allow it to. Or it can lead to more suffering. It depends on what you choose. Life, or existence, or the divine, whatever you choose to call it, is very benevolent. It's like the most loving mother you could ever know. Someone may be confused and think a loving mother just dotes on a child and makes sure they're okay. But a loving mother isn't afraid to do a type of punishment to a child, to put them on the right path. When you're a good mother or father, any type of punishment is to put them on the right path. It's not out of ignorance or irritation. It's only to help. It's only coming out of love. And life is like that. Life is coming to you out of love. Any type of suffering you face, or punishment, where you're thinking, why God, why me? It is meant to help you and teach you. It's so easy to forget. The lessons. Many are afraid of suffering, of feeling pain. But the whole reason behind it is to connect. And if you never connect, feeling will get deeper, or worse, you'll become numb. You'll believe in falsehoods. So many people claim to know the right path. But what's right? Who's judging? Is it the righteous path? How many innumerable things can you count aren't right, but others think they're right? So all you can equate that to is that anyone who tries to tell you the right, the correct path is just shrinking existence down. It's shrinking your path down. And the possibilities are infinite. You can't shrink it down and be right. Even if someone knows their own path and they're sure it's not yours, you have to find your own way, and maybe that doesn't match with everyone is one. Connect to everything. But you know everything is a duality. I'm thankful for every bit of suffering, every lesson that has come my way in this lifetime. It has brought me to where I am now. It's helped wake me up. I can't even imagine where I would be, or maybe I can, without the lessons. I would do it all over again in a heartbeat. And it seems as though nothing else could reach me. And maybe there's another path. But this was mine. And no one can judge that. I'm thankful for every lesson I've had. Lately, I've been trying to connect deeper. I've been slowing down even more. That's why this channel has dropped down somewhat in the amount of videos I post. I greatly appreciate all my viewers. You all help me to grow in a lot of ways. And I'll take any lesson I can get. It can be very painful to come out of the denials. Realize the suffering is there to help you. You have to come out of your denials. It can be hard when you're still in the middle of your pain to be thankful for the suffering. To know that it's there for a reason. But in order to move forward, in order to let go, you have to face it. You have to come out of your denial. I've been stuck in denial before, and it doesn't serve at all. It will keep you in a perpetual discordance that will inevitably lead to your demise, whether it's physically, mentally, spiritually, or all the above. You don't want it. You need to be able to let everything go, which means come to face the real you, not the masks of society. What society is. Society has just bombarded you with such falsities, such wretched information. It's there to just confuse you and keep you down so you can never really connect. You'll never connect to your heart, to the earth, to whatever's beyond the earth. Let go of what everyone else expects you to be, or what you expect you to be. Accept what you really are. You need to open. It's the most important thing you can do. It's just open.